Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulihi al-ameen. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'een. Amma ba'd. Honorable President, highly qualified judges, and dear all, today I want to speak on the topic of Islam prohibits violence, promotes peace and justice. It has always been seen in the history of Muslims that wherever they went, they made their environment peaceful to live in. And its prime reason is that Islamic social system is based on peace and solidarity. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been reported to have said, المسلم من سلم الناس من لسانه ويده والمؤمن من أمنه الناس على دمائهم وأموالهم. The Muslim is the one from whose tongue and hand the people are safe, and the believer is the one from whom the people's lives and wealth are safe. Sunan al-Nasai, hadith number 4995. This part of hadith clearly states that it's not Muslims' only responsibility to take care of their brothers in Islam. Rather, all human beings have right over them to be taken care of and protected by them. This is the key point which introduces Islam as preacher of peace and harmony and Muslims as ambassadors of peace. To inculcate this ideology of peace in the hearts of people, the Prophet has warned those who oppose this of horrible consequences. Thus, Jarir bin Abdullah radiallahu anhu reported, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La yarhamullahu man la yarhamun nas. Allah will not be merciful to those who are not merciful to mankind. Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 7376. This hadith also has a general meaning that every individual deserves to be treated with kindness irrespective of his religion, caste, color, and creed. Dear learned audience, if we analyze the backdrop of prophetic mission profoundly, it tells us that Almighty Allah has sent down the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the people who were surrounded by such problems which were created by themselves. But the Prophet made them free from horrible chain of those problems. That's why he is considered a Messiah. Theoretically, the solution of problems is in ease. And due to this philosophy, the focus of Islamic teachings is to provide comfort in one's life through various deeds. In this regard, a very beautiful message of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is found in the collection of a hadith. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to send his companions to different places for the sake of preaching Islam, he always admonished them, Yassiru wa la tu'assiru wa sakkinu wa la tunaffiru. Make things easy and do not make them difficult. Cheer the people up by conveying glad tidings to them and do not repulse them. Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith number 6125. It clearly means to present Islam before the people in such manner that fills their hearts with inspiration and exhilarates them, and not to introduce religion as strange and horrible so that they abhor it, rather to present it as a religion of peace and mercy. It's obvious that when people observe that the Islamic teachings create ease and serenity in all lives, and peace is obtained through its divine messages, their hearts spontaneously will incline to comfort of Islam, because peace is nothing but a comfortable life in which a person is free in his day-to-day routine. By this point of view, the ease created by Islam and peace stand side by side. Esteemed audience, here is a very important question that if Muslims are such ambassadors of peace in the guidance of Islamic teachings, then why they are being treated with intolerance and violence all over the world, including India? While logically, everyone must be sympathetic for those who try to establish peace. Some analysts say The Muslims are oppressed throughout the world due to deep conspiracy of anti-Islamic elements. This may be the right to an extent, but matter of fact is that Muslims are being targeted because of their own evil and bad actions. They themselves are far away from the Islamic teachings which prevent serenity, happiness and peace to prevail all over the world. Dear brothers in Islam, as a community, Muslims must realize that if they have some rights over their neighbors, fellow citizens and ruler, they have also many rights over them which we have to carry out as a responsible nation. Islam taught us how to treat the fellow citizens and how to invite them towards peace with wisdom. Are we fulfilling our responsibility? Surely not. It's indeed a big reason of lacking peace in our lives. Today, Muslims' tragedy is that even though they accept the Holy Quran as a sacred book of Allah and they claim to love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, but unfortunately, neither they comply with the wonderful teachings of Quran nor they are truthful in their claims of love. We should consider that love means to be ready to offer every sort of sacrifice for loved ones. Do we love our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam to this extent? Remember, Muslims will be besieged with multiple problems until they reach required standard of love. Dear audience, in short, for Muslim community, there is only one way out from being oppressed, and that is to turn face completely towards Almighty Allah and to determine to follow the path of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in every walk of life, giving up the slavery of all transient worldly things. Here I conclude my talk. وآخر دعوان أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.